Welcome back to Teresa's Dead. My name is Teresa and I'm very much
hands.
Hi. Kind of want to do like a lava lamp thing here. Okay, it's not really working because I kind of want to do the Macarena. All right, hi. I have an awful garbage filthy mouth, so viewer discretion is advised, okay? And listen, if you're not into that or weird stuff in general, this is definitely not the place for you. Feel free to X out the video here. No harm, no foul, but I'll remember our Tom fondly. We have an Ipsy Glam Bag Plus unboxing. Super excited. Look at this bag. It's Halloween, bitch. I fucking love that. That is so fucking cute. Finally, a bag that's quite adorable. Hey, y'all, do you remember when Ipsy Glam Bag Plus first came out and they actually had nice bags? What happened? I don't know. But we have this bag. Look at this. I mean, this is cute. Like, I do love the little laundry bag motif. It's fun. But this is actually really adorable. It's like little vampire teethies. A fan. Now, with that said, if you've never heard of Ipsy Glam Bag Plus, well, bitch, let me tell you a little bit about it.
Glam Bag Plus retails for $28. All the faves you love full size. Glam Bag Plus delivers you 5 personalized full size beauty products worth over $120 in a themed drawstring bag. Whether you're trying the best and busiest brands or restocking your supply, there's always so much to love because you get to pick 3 out of the 5 products each month.
Okay, so here's the dealio. This is gonna be a bad bag, okay? A bad batch, bitch, because the products that I could pick were nothing to write home about. I think the most exciting thing perhaps was a Viseart palette and I wound up skipping it because I was like, I got one last time and I'm probably never gonna fucking use it. So with that said, let's open it up. Okay. Without further ado, the theme for this month is pretty wicked. Fangs out, lipstick on. This month, embrace the unconventional. Vampy lips, rich shadows, pitch black manis, and you just might want some more. Oh my god, fucking, who writes this? All right, they have a little pamphlet. Usually it has some garbage in here, but let's see what the garbage they have this time. Last minute Halloween plans. DIY these 3 easy makeup looks. Okay, that sounds kind of cute. You already own everything you need for a killer costume. Here's how to shop your stash for a party ready look in no time. Getting twiggy with it. Oh my god. Time travel to the 60s with short flicks of liquid liner along the lash line and a sharp line above your crease. Top with a generous amount of mascara. Groovy, baby. All I can think of is Austin Powers, which by the way, I did watch Austin Powers 1 and 2 recently. Still hold up. They're still fun. I mean, they're not the best, but like, They were fun, okay? Remember when Mike Myers was a thing? Yeah, me too. All right, ghostly glam, hauntingly beautiful. Use a damp beauty sponge to dab white eyeshadow mixed with a bit of water over your foundation. That just sounds like a recipe for disaster. Blend black eyeshadow around your eyes for a sunken in effect. Okay, and then we have Fairy Queen. Burst out your pixie dust, aka glitter, and use it on top of a shimmery lid in any color you choose, high points on the face, or even your brows for an all-over ethereal look, not to mention the bukkake that you'll be cleaning off your face later. Okay, so get to know your glam bag plicks, blah, 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 blah. And then we have Glam Bag X, which I believe is coming out in December, is gonna be Huda Beauty. Okay. And then you're gonna get a free 1-1-1-1-1-1-1 skin product if you do pick it up. All right, okay. So Huda Beauty, there's gonna be some Rare Beauty, Sunday Riley. Ugh, Sunday Riley, I always break out from it. That's why I'm like, meh. Wishful, Freck. Oh yeah, what the fuck is Freck? I feel like I see everyone talking about Freck. What's Freck? Someone tell me what Freck is. What's Freck? Should I get on if on Freck? How old do I sound? Should I get on the Freck?
What's the frick?
Okay, I'm gonna shut up. So let's start with the products that I actually picked. And the first one is from Rowan. And this is a cake mascara in black. I remember getting a Rowan product. Was it through Ipsy? Yeah, I think it was like a lip product or something like that. Anyway, I wanted to try more stuff from the brand. And this guy retails for $28. It's a mascara, duh. And it's described as, this volumizing mascara has a unique fluffy brush. It's designed with flexible bristles that lengthen and lift from the root to the lash that plumps and lengthens lashes while coating them in intense black pigment that never cake or flake. All right, let's see, what is so spectacular about this brush? This is like a long brush head. This is a thick dick, boys. All right, this is pretty long. Huh, is mascara usually this long? Wow, am I stupid? Hold on, wait a second. Let me open up the Charlotte one. No, I guess, yeah. Wow, why does that seem so long? Wait a second. Y'all, I'm so stupid, okay? I don't know why, but it just felt like I was looking at mascara for the first time. It just felt like it was extra big. I'm sorry, that's all I can actually say. But in any case, I'm excited to try it. I love how it says like, cake, 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 cake. Oh, I love it. All right, listen, I'm not gonna lie. So I had a choice between the Viseart palette or this. And listen, I'm just a slut for housewives, okay? And even though I think Lisa Rinna, own it! Like, I can't. This season, she was just such a little shit. But anyway, sometimes I really do love her because she's so fucking kooky and it just makes me laugh. But I wanted to try her Rinna Beauty. I really was like, so kind of intrigued to try this out, and it's such you know what, it's actually not that bad. It's a very pretty component, it's very basic, and this lip gloss retails for $19, and it's basically soft, smooth, shiny, ultra shimmery. One swipe of the champagne pink gloss instantly makes lips look more full and juicy. The formula is ultra lightweight and it feels comfy, not gooey, but rich enough to last on your lips for hours. Listen, if it wasn't a housewife, I would never fucking even consider this, but because it's a housewife, I need to have it, okay? Like, just as much as I want the fucking Karen's candles for fucking Real Housewives of Potomac, I need to have this. So hold, please. I want to try it. Do I feel like Lisa Rinna? Maybe. Should I go get a duster from QVC? Absolutely. I actually like the product. It feels quite lovely on the lips. It feels nice. It's a very pretty basic bitch color, which I'm all about, and I don't hate it. Like, I actually like this, and I am very happy to have this. This is guilty pleasure. Oh my God, I love it. Bitch, I love it. Okay, I love it. I absolutely love it. This is great. This is everything that I want it to be and more, and I can't wait to own it, okay? This is so good. Yay! And then last but not least, the best thing that I could pick was this brush set. These brushes are like straight out of the fucking 90s. Oh my God, it's like Lovecraft Beauty. Okay, so these feel cheap. Not gonna lie. These retail for $55. Oh, no they don't. Oh, no they don't. Oh, hell no. Oh my God, these are some of the... Wow, this can't be. That's not right. That is not right. Okay, so this apparently retails for $55. They feel very cheap. The bristles feel very hard and plasticky. You don't feel nice. None of this. The weight of it, like, it just feels like cheap plastic. All of it. It's just, I hate it. I hate all of this. So basically, this is a blend contour shade and detail like a total makeup pro with a 5-piece brush kit. Wow, okay. As someone who has, like, all different kinds of brushes from, like, real hair to synthetic or whatever, if you are looking for like really, you know, good brushes at a fraction of the price, try ColourPop, try e.l.f. They have really good brushes. Moda, fantastic. If you're looking for, you know, more synthetic brushes, shit, Sigma is fine. If you want natural, Reffer is a great starting point. Bristol's Beauty, especially for like a lower price point, unless you want to like upgrade to the Mac Daddy, the Sonia G's, the Wing Goss, whatever, right? But anyway, the point is that there's a lot of, you know, different prices for brushes. And I just don't understand how this warrants a $55 price tag. Like, no, bro, no. I'm usually a firm believer, like, I can't have enough brushes, but like this, you couldn't pay me to fucking use it. So, that was a miss on my part. That was a miss on my part. Cool. Okay. Fuck that. These are so fucking cheap feeling. Honestly, I would suggest you to go buy Morphe brushes than this shit. Crown brushes. Shit. Anything. Anything. This is pure garb. Okay, so that was really super disappointing. So let's move on to the two products that were picked for me. And this is from Wanda Beauty. Love me some Wanda Beauty. And this is the Staycation Hydrating Mask. Ooh, fun. Okay, fun, fun, fun. So this retails for $38, and this is a face mask. This fast-acting formula helps restore moisture levels, soothe inflammation, plump fine lines and wrinkles, and improve skin texture with a blend of ceramides, plant oils, and peptides. All right, that's not bad, not bad. Fun, fun, fun. And this is sealed, so we'll keep it sealed. But listen, I do like Wonder Beauty. I'm interested in trying it. And then last but certainly not least, we have the brand Dermalect. And this is a $42 serum. And this is the Self-Esteem Beauty Sleep Serum. This face and neck serum uses a blend of firming amino acids, exfoliating acids, and antioxidant-rich vitamin C to dramatically help smooth and brighten skin while you sleep. So, okay, okay. Let's see how big this bitch is. All right, it's a not bad. Okay. I love that the bottle's red. It reminds me of blood. And that's all I gotta say about that. So let's see. Oh, do love a good yellow serum. Kinda wanna just put it on my hand. See how wonderful it is. Oh, ooh, it smells like alcohol. Ooh, like, I just got like a whiff of, this is gonna sound very specific, but okay, so Bacardi 151 has like these really weird mixers. So they have like a Long Island iced tea one. They're not good, okay? Like it's pre-made Long Island iced tea. And then they have a hurricane one. Did they have a zombie? Anyway, I used to drink this back in 2006 with my best friend Michael. And they're disgusting. They're disgusting. I'm pretty sure it was made up of gasoline, most of it. But in any case, it's reminding me of like 2006, reminding me of the boyfriend I had at the time and how weird and flaky his skin was. So let's just say I'm not having the best moment of my life with this. So I don't know if I can use it because it evokes such a horrible time. So we're going to package him up. We're gonna move him away, but that shit stinks. Ooh, I do not like that. And by the way, I realized I just put the Rinna Beauty on my mouth. I didn't actually show you what the color was on my hand. So let me show you what that looks like. Although I'm pretty sure it's gonna be hard to tell, but beautiful basic bitch color. I actually really like this. I'm quite surprised. Feels super comfortable on my lips. Like I'm really liking it. Wow. Okay, so this is October stuff. To say I'm disappointed is an understatement. Holy shit. I think the best thing is the bag and the Rinna Beauty and the oddly long but not really long cake mascara thingy. And I could fuck up the Wander Beauty stuff. Like, Wander Beauty never did anything to me. Like, Wander Beauty's a good kid. I could fuck with that. This is, this is equivalent to every overpricing you find in a DSW. The fuck out of here. And this just evokes horrible memories. So no thank you. You know, Ipsy, I keep waiting for the day things get better and I, you know, and they don't. And maybe one day I'll learn. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know, we'll see. Let me know down below if you get Ipsy Glam Bag Plus. If this was your bag or if you got something else, because I'd love to hear from you. And let me know how disappointed you are. Because again, I love hearing about that. So with that said, I want to say thank you so much for watching. I truly appreciate it as always. Feel free to like, comment, hit that subscribe button. It's free. And hit that bell icon for notification of all my future posts. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Patreon, to all my beautiful, wonderful patron bubbies. Thank you so much for keeping this delicious, disgusting, filthy, trashy, really filthy, really disgusting garbage boat float. I couldn't do it without you. I love your adorable little delicious faces. With my beautiful Rinna lips, I want to kiss your face. Sounds really weird when I say it like that, but you know what I mean. I love you. If you want to know what is currently on my nails and where to get this shit, everything will be listed in the description box below. And I'll see you little lollipops later. Bye. You like that? I love it. I could do this all night.